Hello, hardware hackers. I am Zach Friedman, and today I have 10 useful prints that every hobbyist should make. I have just one question. Does this rag smell like chloroform to you? Oh, you're awake. Welcome to my super sketchy secret lair. My 3D printer lives here so I can keep prints running after hours. Don't worry about the electrical tape. I've been told it's fully non-conductive. Today, we are going to give my printer the workout of the century as we make 10 clever devices that you should have. Be sure to stay till the very end because I have a special surprise for all you Dremel fans. Enough talk. The prints must flow.
Number 10. Mouse BUNGEE by Peter Murho.
I like wired mice. They never run out of battery, they never lag, and you can't really, you know, find high-quality lefty cordless mice. You can print this thing in about 3 hours and 45 minutes, and it snaps together. It holds the cable safely above desktop debris so it can't sweep or snag stray stuff. It has 2 points of articulation, and each have a ball bearing, so movement is super smooth. If you do make this, I would recommend using a high-quality filament. Those SnapFit connectors also like to snap off.
Uh-oh.
Number 9, USB cable holder by Philip Kolb.
Actual mathematicians have proven with actual mathematics that when you agitate a cable, it will automatically form knots. This fun fact means that your tidiest tub of cables will inevitably degenerate into a Lovecraftian hellscape as you rummage through it. This USB cable holder is perfect for banishing knot theory from your workshop while making use of otherwise worthless wall space. What I really like about this one is that it holds the business end of the cable. You can keep the other end plugged into a USB hub, so a live cable is always available to charge your stuff. It's pretty handy.
Number 8, Camera Rig for Smartphones by Willie Beckman.
If you've ever wondered how I do these buttery smooth shots, it's because I put my iPhone in this exact model. A camera rig will never be as good as a gimbal or a dolly, unless you're in a wheelchair, but it's a hell of a lot cheaper. There's a lot to like about this particular model. It's really easy to assemble with just 4 nuts, 4 bolts, 4 screws, and 1 spring. It'll also take a few minutes to print, 19 hours and 15 minutes to be exact, and it uses like 200 grams of filament. But that said, the design is very forgiving. The spring-loaded phone clamp handles all kinds of phones and cases. There's even a handy quarter-inch threaded hole and a shutter button clip so you can attach some accessories.
Number 7. Battery inserts for ALTOIDS tins by Dave312.
Lithium batteries are f***ing terrifying. These things will blow up your handbag, incinerate your jeans, kick your dog, and run off with your wife. So let's put them in a metal tin. These handy inserts nest into ALTOIDS tins and turn them into Keter-class secure power containment. Each one prints with no supports or anything in about 2.5 hours, and they all perfectly fit in a tin with no cleanup required. Oh, ALTOIDS, those $3 project boxes with a handful of free breath mints. Did you know that the Arduino, the BeagleBone, and the Raspberry Pi were all specifically sized to fit one of these? So why not keep your rechargeable breath battery mint cells in the bonus model?
Number 7.5, ALTOIDS Tin Selector Rack by John Plunkett.
It's not the most elegant ALTOIDS containment system, but it does have a little push button that ejects your ALTOIDS. Makes me feel like I'm in the engine room of the USS Enterprise. Except the engine room of the USS Enterprise always has electrical fires.
Number 6, Screw Sorting Jig Double Whammy. Metric by James Leonard, Imperial by Emmy Zinn.
Don't you hate it when this happens? Or when this happens? We can 3D print our way out of this. These jigs have little slots and lines to help you figure out the threading of common screws as well as their length. I like to bring these things to the hardware store because sometimes Karen can't be bothered to put her screws back in the right box. What are you? You can print the model as normal and switch filament to a contrasting color for the text. That way you have sharp, easy-to-read legends that never wear off, unless you're me and you printed the letters in ABS. If you're gonna print anything on this list, you should definitely print these things because if you're anything like me, you have a massive pile of disorganized screws and you've been using this as an excuse not to sort them. The jig is up, meh!
Number 5, Unlockable Loose Filament Spool by Christoph Flamer. By the way, have you subscribed? More maker videos every Monday. Call to action, baby.
You ever buy some filament from an Amazon seller whose name is almost pronounceable by humans and they throw in one of those annoying filament samples? Every single time I try to print with one of those obnoxious little hanks of filament, it guarantees ties itself in a knot and the printer implodes. Damn you, knot theory, damn you to hell! Enter the unlockable filament spool. One side of this thing flips down so you can just whack the entire bundle right on there and start printing. This model has a few nifty features in addition to the flippy bits. It snaps together with absolutely no glue or fasteners anywhere.
Number 4, Feather Fingerboard by Adafruit.
This thing turns your Adafruit feather into a 3-inch long skateboard. I couldn't make this one for you because the trucks and the wheels cannot be 3D printed. And going on a quest to find a tech deck during a global pandemic is just a little too quixotic for me. Psych! I put on a mask, I went to Target, and I bought a tech deck. Of all the dev board enclosures I've found, this is the only one that can land gnarly grinds, dude! It turns out that bolting a microcontroller onto a fingerboard does not make it any easier to do tricks. This whole adventure taught me a very important lesson. I really suck at fingerboarding.
Number 3. The T.U.S.H. by Vasil Gunev.
Gaze upon the T.U.S.H., the ultimate spool holder. Vasil's words, not mine. T.U.S.H. is a one-size-fits-all, low-friction support for all of your weird-shaped spools. Just spread your T.U.S.H. to the appropriate width, get your spool up in there, and start extruding. The T.U.S.H. runs smoothly because the T.U.S.H. is well lubricated. The spool is riding on two ball bearings on each side, again those 608 bearings that you probably already have. The only problem with the T.U.S.H. is that there's no frame or brace. The weight of the filament alone is all that's keeping the T.U.S.H. under lock. If your spool is too tight, or you get tangled up, or your extruder just gives a good yank, your T.U.S.H. can collapse and dump filament all over your table. Just keep your eyes on the T.U.S.H. and be ready to give it some attention. Honestly, I think every 3D printer should have a T.U.S.H. It's small, it's cheap, and when you need some T.U.S.H., you'll have one right there that you can grab.
Number 2. Dispenser for syringe of flux or solder paste by Mordahar.
Every bit of surface mount soldering I do uses either solder paste or flux, and the best way to deliver that from the tube to the pad is this Pico paste press. A mechanical paste press is the best way to deploy a precision blob of the good stuff right where you need it. Problem is, this Pico model got discontinued like 5 years ago. Enter the dispenser for syringe of flux or solder paste. Awful name, decent model. This thing is kind of awkward to print. It has a goofy rubber band on it. It's not nearly as smooth as the Pico model, but it gets the job done. This thing doesn't need springs, doesn't need threaded rod or any other weird hardware. All you need is some filament, some screws, something spongy, and a rubber band. If you do any surface mount work at all, you have got to get one of these. Even though it is, like, I'll admit, really janky. The others are definitely jankier. Maybe I'll make my own one day. I hope not. You could run off 2 copies of everything else in this list and still have enough plastic left for a full-size copy of that stupid, 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 stupid baby Groot. Well, we're throwing that out the window because number 1 is, in the parlance of our times, a big chungus. Cower mortals, for the number 1 3D print of the day is...
Number 1, Workbench Storage, Dremel Bit Storage, by Steve Boswell.
Consuming almost a pound of plastic and wasting 30 hours of straight printing, this is nothing less than the very apex of the workshop flex. Behold this temple, this shrine, this goddamn monument to the king of rotary tools. Every sanding drum, every cutoff disc, every flap wheel is lovingly ensconced in its own custom fit holder. Like a shining stairway to heaven, this colossus of collets collates all of your tools, accessories, and supplies into one place, displaying them all matrix style so you can immediately find the Dremel accessory you need. DIY maker people infer social standing by the quality of one's Dremel, and now everyone who visits Void Star Lab will know the sheer girth of my maker. That was the top 10 list of the 14 3D prints that every maker with a 3D printer should 3D print and make. Links to every model and credit to every author are in the description. Next Monday, we will unpack my mobile workshop go bag that I bring to every offsite mission to build stuff in the field. Hit subscribe and whack that bell to get notified. I am still a new channel and it makes a colossal difference.
Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the future.